Bloomberg News reporter Tyler Kendall caught up with the NVIDIA president, CEO, and co-founder Jensen Huang in Washington, D.C. So we're so delighted to have Tyler with us. So tell us, first of all, Tyler, set the scene. Where was he? Where you caught up with him? Because it sounds like it was like a little doorstepping there.
Yeah, exactly. I had the chance to catch up with the NVIDIA CEO, Jensen Huang, today in Washington, D.C. He was here for a private meeting, and we were able to stop him on his way into that meeting and ask him about some things that are ending up to be pretty newsy, right, as you've been covering that headline that just broke on the terminal about China trying to counter these U.S. export controls, particularly when it comes to artificial intelligence and chips. I had the chance to ask him if he felt that these export controls were effective, and it was pretty interesting. His answer, he was trying to kind of thread the needle there, right, saying that the U.S. government is doing its best to balance what is national security concerns, but also the interests of American companies.
Well, we have to defer all of the policy making to the administration. They understand that the balancing national security versus the prosperity of American technology all over the world.
Now, of course, the U.S. banned NVIDIA from selling its most advanced AI chips to China in 2022. And this has been a part of the Biden administration's work to try to protect U.S. technology and particularly this competition.
Interesting. I love that you were able to ask this question before this news came out. That was pretty brilliant, Tyler. You also talked a little bit about AI and the chips and the data centers necessary to power it all. They, of course, use a ton of energy. We've been talking about this. Oh, what were you going to say?
I was going to say
this
big topic.
Was this climate week? You guys talked about this a lot?
Yeah. I mean, it definitely came up because AI is such a big part of, or it seems to be a growing part of everything we're doing. And
hello, getting a nuclear power plant back online.
And I think about the story that we just talked about over the last week or so about Microsoft and Constellation Energy Three Mile Island,
yeah.
Coming back online, at least part of it, because it's data centers and AI.
Yeah. So Tyler, what did Jensen talk to you about when it came to energy usage and AI?
Exactly. I actually brought up that exact example, this recent deal between Microsoft and Constellation Energy to use nuclear power to power Microsoft's AI energy grid. And I asked him if he felt that nuclear energy could be the way forward when it comes to NVIDIA and their needs for energy and a bigger infrastructure grid to support their technology.
Nuclear is a wonderful way forward as one of the sources of energy, one of the sources of sustainable energy. It won't be the only one. We're going to need energy from all sources and balance the availability and the cost of energy as well as the sustainability over time.
Now, this has been a big topic here in Washington. I'd point you that the NVIDIA CEO was actually at the White House earlier this month, along with a whole other host of AI executives. They had a private meeting at the White House with some pretty senior Biden administration officials, including Energy Secretary Jennifer Granholm and Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo, to talk about just this, the need to boost both the energy grid and also infrastructure needs when it comes to supporting artificial intelligence, whether that's data centers or chip production. I quickly point you to a recent Goldman Sachs analysis which found that data center energy is growing exponentially, partly because of what they're calling this AI revolution. They estimate that energy consumption from data centers is going to go up 160% by 2030, and leaders like NVIDIA's CEO are urging these investments in energy and infrastructure needs to support what's this growing demand.
Hey, any thoughts on the upcoming election? I know anybody who runs a publicly held company is so careful, Tyler, but I'm just curious if anything came out.
So I did ask him if he's been in touch with either of the campaigns, considering that he has made this recent visit to the White House. He told me that he has not, and that he trusts that no matter who wins the White House next, he's going to work with that administration on all things related to AI.
And no leather jacket?
Yeah, what's
today?
Up with that?
You go to Washington, D.C., you wear a suit. If you're Jensen Huang, what's going on?
I have to say, it was pouring rain. It was nice enough that he stopped and talked to me on the sidewalk there, but I'm not sure if a leather jacket would have done so well in the weather today in Washington.
He's a Californian, so he doesn't have to, he's not used to the rain, Carol.
Yeah, well, I mean, right? Yes. What is this stuff coming exactly. down? Pretty amazing. Hey, listen, great great catch and so timely considering the Bloomberg exclusive, and certainly NVIDIA is a company that we talk about, I got to say, on a daily basis.
Absolutely.
So the things that are going on, whether it's AI or NVIDIA specific. So kudos. Tyler Kendall there in D.C., news reporter here at Bloomberg News.